Yes, good morning children. So today we will start the new exercise. Today we will start the new exercise, that is exercise 10.13.8. Okay, because we had already finished up to 13.7 yesterday, so today I am going to start exercise 13.8. So 13.8 is related to your sphere and hemisphere. Okay, so I am taking the first question. The first question is find the volume of the sphere whose radius is given. Okay, the first question is radius is given. Radius is 7 cm in first question, and in second it is 0.63. So only first part I am solving, second you have to solve yourself. So r is equal to 7 cm. Then volume of sphere is what? Volume of sphere is equal to 4/3 π/r. So this will be equal to 4/3. The value of pi is 22/7, and r cube is equal to 7 × 7 × 7. So you can cancel it. So this will be equal to 88 × 49/3. Okay, you multiply it, you get the answer. Okay, you will multiply it and divide by 3, you will get the answer in 7 × 3. So I hope you can do. And second part you can also do, because r is equal to 0.63 is given. Okay, now I am going for the next question, that is question number 2. Question number 2, first part I am telling. First part is find the amount of water displaced by the solid spherical ball of diameter 28 cm. So here diameter of ball is given how much? 28 cm. So therefore radius of the ball will be equal to 28/2, that is 14 cm. This is radius of the ball, 14 cm, and you have to find out the water amount of water displaced by sphere. Amount of water displaced by a spherical ball, that will be volume of the ball, means volume of the sphere. So volume of the sphere is 4/3 π/r³. So 4/3, value of pi is 22/7, and value of r is 14 × 14 × 14. So 7 × 14, and this will be equal to 4 × 22 is 88 × 2 × 14 × 14 is 196/3. Okay, so you will multiply this and divide by 3, you get the answer in cm³. Okay, calculation part is done by you only. I will not be doing the calculation. Okay, so this was the second question. Now, I am solving third question. Question number 3 is the diameter of the metallic ball is 4.2 cm. Diameter of the ball is how much? That is 4.2 cm. So therefore radius of the ball, that will be r, equal to 4.2/2. So that is 2.1 cm. This is the radius of the ball. And what is the mass of the ball? if the density of the material is 8.9 gram per centimeter cube, means you will find out its mass after finding out the volume. So first of all, find out the volume of the ball. So volume of the ball, volume of the ball will be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. So 4 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7, right? And r is 2.1 into 2.1 into 2.1. So 7, these are 21. And you can cancel it by 3, 0.1. So this is 88 into 0.1 into 21 into 21 is 441. This 4.41. Right? Calculate this. 88 into 0.1 is 8.8. And this is 4.41. Multiply this. When we multiply by 8.8, what is the answer? 4.41 into 8.8. That will be equal to 38.808 cm³. Now, you need to find out the mass of the ball. So, as we know that mass of the ball will be equal to volume into density. Okay. So volume is 38.808 and density is what?
Density is given
how much?
Density is 8.9 gram per centimeter cube. 8.9 gram.
So multiply this. 8.9 into 38.808. Eight point nine. That will be equal to 345.39 grams. Okay. If you want to convert into kg, you can also convert into kg by dividing 1000. So 345.39 divided by 1000 kg. So that will be equal to 0.34539 kg. Okay. Understood? Yes, please note down. Because always try to convert the smaller unit into higher unit. Okay. But answer is given in only grams. Answer is given in only grams, so you don't need to change. यदि आप change कर भी दिए तो कोई बात नहीं. Otherwise, answer is given in gram. In gram, 345.39 gram is the correct answer. यदि आप kg में convert नहीं करोगे तो चलेगा. Okay. So I am moving forward. Now, question number 4 is very important question. The question is, the diameter of the moon is approximately 1/4 of the diameter of the earth. Right? So first of all, assume that the diameter of the moon and diameter of the earth. Let the diameter of the moon is suppose Q R, Q capital R, right? And the diameter of the earth is 2 small r.
Both are different objects, so that must be having the different radius, right? Different variables, 2r and 2r. And what is given here?
It is given that diameter of moon is approximately 1/4 into diameter of Earth. It is given. This is the question. So diameter of moon is what? 2r, and this is 1/4, and diameter of Earth is 2r. So both sides 2 to cancel. So capital R is equal to small r by 4. Okay, this is the relation. And now it is asking that what fraction of the volume of earth is volume of the moon. अब पूछ रहे हैं कि volume of earth और volume of moon का fraction क्या होगा, means ratio क्या होगा. So we will find out volume of earth upon volume of moon. Find out volume of moon. So both are having the same spherical shape, means both are spheres. So what is the volume of earth? Volume of sphere is 4/3π, and radius of the earth will be equal to 2r. Diameter of the earth is 2r, then radius of the earth will be equal to r. This is equal to 4/3π r³. And radius of the moon is smaller, so this will be equal to 4/3π R³. So 4/3, 5 by cancel. That is R³/R³. Now, what is the value of R here? So this R³ will remain as it is, and value of capital R is R/4³. So this becomes what? That is R³ by 4 × 16 = 64. So R³ into ये ट्रांसफॉर्म हो गया 64/R³, या तो R³ कैंसिल 1, तो 64/1, right? So volume of earth is equal to 64 times of volume of moon. Okay, volume of earth will be 64 times of volume of moon. This is 64:1. The ratio will be 64:1. This is very good question. Please note down. So in the question, it is given that volume of earth to moon, that will be equal to 64:1, 64/1. I mean, if you want to find out the volume of moon to earth, then it will be equal to 1/64. So it is up to you. Either you can take volume of earth first and volume of moon second, or volume of moon in the numerator and volume of earth in the denominator. In that case, it is instead of 1/64/1, it will be 1/64. Both the answers are correct. Now, I move on to next question. The next question is,
Yes. Question number 5.
Question number 5 is, question number 5, how many liters of milk can a hemispherical bowl of diameter 10.5 cm hold? A hemispherical bowl hai. This is the bowl, hemispherical bowl, and is you need to find the capacity of milk in this bowl. Capacity of milk. Then diameter is given, how much? Diameter is 10.5 cm. So then radius will be equal to 10.5 by 2 cm. Okay. So you need to find the capacity of the milk in the bowl. The capacity of milk, capacity of milk, milk, capacity of milk in the bowl, capacity of milk in the bowl will be equal to, that is in the hemispherical shape. So what is the volume of hemisphere is 2 by 3 pi r. So this is equal to 2 by 3, value of pi is 22 by 7, and r cube is 10.5 by 2 into 10.5 by 2 into 10.5 by 2. Okay, so this 2 and this 2 is cancelled, and 2 ones are, and this is 3, 3 threes are 9, 3 fives are 15, and this is 7, 7 fives are 35. So 55 into 11, 11 fives are 55, that is 5.5, right, into 10.5 into 10.5 by only 2 is remaining. So 5.5 into 10.5 into 10.5, that is 110.25 upon 2. So just you divide it, you'll get the answer. That will be equal to 606.375 divided by 2. That is equal to 303.1875 centimeter cube. But that as it is capacity, so you can find out the answer in it is given that how many liters of milk? If you will convert this into liter, how will you convert this into liter? 303.1875 divided by 1000 liter. Why? Since 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 by 1000 liter. Right? 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 by 1000 liter. When you divide by 3, it will be approximately 0.303.1875 liter. This is the final answer. Or you can remove this, because after decimal, either you will take 2, maximum 2 or 3 places. So either you can remove this, or you can keep it as it is. There is no problem with this. Okay? Please note down. Now, so moving forward for the next question. The next question is question number 6. Question number 6 is, a hemispherical tank is made up of an iron sheet 1 cm thick. If the inner radius is 1 meter
and find the volume of the iron used to make the tank.
So first of all, see the question. There is a hemispherical tank. Right? And its thickness is how much? Its thickness is 1 centimeter. Thickness is 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter. Iski jo motai hai 1 centimeter. And if the inner radius is 1 meter, this is the inner radius. This is called R. That is how much? That is 1 meter. It is thickness is 1 centimeter and this is 1 meter.
So you need to find the volume of iron used to make the tank. So what do we do?
First of all, we assume that let the outer and inner radii of the bound be R and R respectively. What does it mean? Outer and inner. Outer is capital R and inner is smaller. Outer radius is capital R and inner radius is smaller. Inner radius is smaller. Right? So we need to find the volume of iron used. So first of all, these two different parameters, this is in centimeter and this is in meter. So we will equalize both the parameters, right? So R is equal to small r is equal to given 1 meter, right? And thickness is given, thickness of sheet is given 1 centimeter. So that must be converted into what? That must be converted into meter. So thickness will be, how will you find out the thickness? Dekho, ye aapka bar, ye outer radius ho gaya, that is capital R, and inner radius is small r. So yadi main outer radius mein se inner radius minus kar dun, then we will get the thickness. So thickness will be equal to capital R minus small r, and 1 centimeter will be converted into meter, 1 centimeter. So that will be equal to 1/100 meter. So capital R, we don't know capital R, but value of small r is 1 meter, and this will be equal to 0.01 meter. So capital R will be equal to 1 plus 0.01. So capital R is 1.01 meter. Okay.
Now we'll find out volume of iron used to make the tank.
अब इसको बनाने में, इस बाउल को बनाने में,
इसलिए इस बाउल ऑफ व्हाट? टैंक है, सॉरी टैंक है, हेमिस्फेरिकल टैंक है,
कितने सब शीट तो दिए हैं, ठीक है, रेडियस ऑफ द बाउल नहीं है, ऑफ द टैंक है, हेमिस्फेरिकल टैंक है. Okay, so volume of iron used to make the tank, that will be equal to outer wala radius, outer wala volume mein se inner wala volume minus kar do. So what will be the outer volume? Outer volume will be equal to 2/3 pi r³, and inner volume will be equal to 2/3 pi r³. So here 2 pi 3 and pi is common in both. What will it be remaining? R cube minus R cube. So 2 pi 3 into pi is 22 by 7. Capital R is 1.01 cube and this is 1 cube. Okay. So this is 44 by 21 into. This will be equal to 1.01 into 1.01 into 1.01 minus 1 into 1 into 1. Now, अब क्या होगा देखो. Now what will be happen now? So this is 44 by 21 into 1.01 into 1.01 into 1.01. That will be equal to 1.03 0301, and 1 into 1 into 1 is only 1. So 44 by 21 into, when you subtract this from 1, this will, you will get 0.03 0301. Multiply this by 44, you will get 45.33244 divided by 21, you will get 2.12. That will be 2.12 meter cube. Right? This is your final answer. So, volume of iron used to make this tank will be equal to 2.12 meter cube. Now we will check the answer. There is something wrong. Question number 6 now. I mean, spherical tank is made of 1 centimeter thickness is 1.100 centimeter. The inner radius is 1 meter. The inner radius is 1 meter. So small r is 1 meter and outer radius is 1.01 meter. So this will be equal to volume of the iron used to make the tank, that is hemisphere 2 by 3 pi r cube minus 2 by 3 pi r cube. I think there is something, we have made some mistake in calculation. So let me check. 1.01 2 by 3 pi is 22 by 7. 44 by 21, 1.01 the power 3, 1.03 0301 minus 1, that will be equal to 0.03 0301 into 44 is 0.03 0301 into 44 is ये गलत आया हमारा. This is wrong. We have multiplied this one wrongly. So this will be equal to 44 into this will be equal to 1.33 3 3 3 2 4 by 21. So when you divide this by 21, you will get 0.06 3, 4. This is the final answer. And meter cube. This is your final answer. Right?
So we can check the answer once again. So 03348. Yes. This is the final answer. Okay. So this is now we will close today because we have completed to question number 6. Okay. So remaining question will see that in next class. Till then, goodbye.